Hey, what's going on, guys? SFC here, bringing you my second episode of this TTT / Time to Talk. And this is episode 2, obviously. Today's topic is that EA are robbing you, and I'm going to tell you why in a bit. But this is my BPL team. This is my second team, actually, because look at all these first team players, and then this team. This is actually the first time it's ever gotten to 79 rated. So, kind of sucks, but what can you do? And, so it's 79 rated, which is really bad, but I'm going to try to get into this and win a game, because my highest is, like, 82, but let's go. And so he has an 84 rated 100 chem team. He has Ibra, Lucas, forgot his name, Kabai, Verratti, Matuidi, Lavezzi, Bedemo, David Luiz, Thiago Silva, Vanderweel, and Sirigu. That's a really good team. Hopefully we can stop it, but so I'm going to tell you why EA are robbing us, basically you, everyone. EA, as you guys know, FIFA 16 has come out a few days ago. I actually did record this, which kind of sucks, and then, I wasn't recording the audio, but that sucks, but I guess I'm going to have to do this commentary all over again. So yeah, as you guys know, FIFA 16 came out. There's so much hype about it and stuff, and last week, I was actually watching an MGH video on career mode, his Arsenal career mode, and someone commented, I was reading the comments, and someone was like, why isn't there any training on Xbox 360, and I was like, what? This can't be. So, and then I went to do some research, and I went on the forums, and then it turns out that there actually is no training on Xbox 360. And I was like, what do you mean? I just thought that the disappearing spray wasn't on the old-gen consoles. But basically, FIFA 16 sucks on the old-gen consoles. So I was like, what? This is so unfair. Like, it's kind of like EA are trying to take your money. And what I mean by that is, well, basically what I just said, but, you know, I think EA are stealing your money in a way, because they know that people with next-gen consoles probably have more money, and they, you know, more people are trying to buy it, but I know that a lot of people do have old-gen consoles, which really pisses me off. Like, I have a YouTube channel, and I, you know, I'm not fortunate enough to have a next-gen console, and that really pissed me off that they're not going to have the new features, which, because they advertise something and then they don't have it. That's false advertising. And I don't know if that shouldn't be legal. And I mean, might not be in some places, but you know, I think that's really dumb how they false advertise something, even though, yeah, next gen has it, but it's still false advertising because not every console has it, because they didn't say old gen wasn't gonna have it, you know? So that pissed me off. Like, how can EA do something like that? I think they basically, like, they're punishing, like, people who don't have as much money to buy a next-gen console. And don't get me wrong, a lot of people have old-gen consoles. So, like, I don't know why they think they're losing business. But it's really dumb. Because someone who isn't, like, a really big fan of FIFA or football in general, they might not want to, like, spend too much money on a game, a football game, if they're not too interested in football and stuff, and then they come out and then give them a crappy game, and they're like, what, this game sucks, and then, you know, they don't really know that the game is actually good, it's just that EA didn't do too much to it, you know, and at least for old gen, like, if they have old gen or whatever, and that really disappoints me, how EA are doing something like that, because I legit, what a goal from Juve, I legit thought, and I still think this, that FIFA is the best football game there is, and EA could really improve that if, instead of just worrying about getting money, they should worry about making the gameplay better, but I'll get into that in a few minutes after I finish what I'm talking about here. What a save. So, also, what they did to a scheme to take your money was during the team of the season. In the first team of the season thing, they spammed team of the season in packs, And I think that's what EA was doing. They were spamming the team of the seasons. Why did I chip it? Just so people would, you know, buy packs and FIFA points. And they even got me to do it because I was seeing a bunch of YouTubers getting amazing team of the seasons. And so I went to buy FIFA points as well. And so basically they were trying to get their company money, which is cool, right? I mean, yeah, everyone wants to have money and have a fortune at company. But they should, I don't know, I think they're already getting enough money. They have a bunch of games. And although they probably spent all year on FIFA and stuff, I feel like they don't prioritize their fan base and what they want. Like, for example, price ranges. It didn't affect me too much, so I can't even complain. But everyone hated it. I know that everyone did. And, you know, EA weren't doing anything to fix it, which kind of means, like, whoa, you don't, like, you're not listening to your fan base. Like, for example, I'm a YouTuber, right? And I post YouTube videos, but it's for you guys. And whoa, yeah, I post videos for you guys. So, you know, I think it's important for you guys to, you know, like what I'm seeing. Because if I wasn't making videos for myself, I wouldn't care, right? But like FIFA, and I guess I'm making videos for other people for their enjoyment. And if I constantly don't listen to you, it won't get you guys intrigued. And EA are focusing on more of selling than, I guess, selling in a way. Because they are focusing on selling, you know, getting copies and stuff, but they're not focusing on their fan base, which could make them lose money as well. Because I would be pissed off. Like, I am pissed off that EA have no consideration for, you know, old-gen consoles. That's really dumb because a lot of people have old-gen. So, I mean, they could be losing money as well if they're going to do something like that. I guess they want people, richer people, to play their game, which is also really dumb because, you know, I guess they'll have more money to buy FIFA points. But that's something really, you know, it's like they don't care about their subscribers, kind of thing like that, which I think is unfair, I guess. And what I said, I was going to get into the talk about, what's it called, how they should focus on quality. They have the potential to be the best football game. In my opinion, they already are, but I think they have such good potential to be, like, something really amazing, like, better than they are right now. But I feel like they don't care. If they cared more, then I feel like, oh, shoot, Ibra. Okay. Yeah, if they cared more, their game would be so successful. Like, I can't complain about their graphics because their graphics are amazing in FIFA 15 and 16, I guess. But to be fair, they didn't really improve the graphics too much from this year's game to FIFA 16, which, I mean, I'm not too bothered just because FIFA 15 graphics were amazing. But, you know, I feel like if they focus less on, like, trying to sell and try to make their game, like, the best game they could make, then I legit think that people will be more interested in football games, not only maybe even football. Like, maybe we have, you know, more people watching it, and it not only gets them up, but it gets, you know, gets them way above PES, because PES is slowly catching up to FIFA, and, you know, FIFA are starting to get pissed off, and they do drastic decisions like that, which can really cost them. So, I mean, I don't know, just tell me what you guys think about that. And also, if you guys have FIFA 16, also tell me down in the comments. And once again, another also, what do you guys think that they couldn't add in FIFA 17? I know this is a little bit early to say anything about FIFA 16, but, you know, just tell me what you think they should do in FIFA 17. And that I tried to do a cheeky finish. Because I'm actually kind of interested, you know, maybe they can, you know, some things, people who have already played 16, maybe they want something better than this. And tell me if you guys like FIFA 16, because I've heard, like, a lot of mixed emotions about it. Like, a lot of YouTubers like it, but a lot of their subscribers, like I've seen in the comments, don't like FIFA. And it's cool, I guess. But, you know, FIFA, it's just about getting used to it. Like, I'm not good at the demo, but I feel like if they got adapted to the game, and EA made it more realistic, which is cool. Like, I love that EA made it more realistic. But, you know, because since the graphics were, like, not that good. Well, not that good. I mean, they didn't change too much. I guess making it more realistic kind of balanced it. But some people didn't like it. And I feel like EA did a great job from what I've seen on the game. But I know that they can do better. Like, 100% know they can do better. Not just on the gameplay, but on the features and stuff. I mean, the draft, I knew it was cool, but I knew people were going to get tired of it really early on. And I guess that hasn't happened, kind of, I guess. But, you know, people don't really, I guess they think the draft is kind of similar. Like, there's a lot of BBVA teams. And the guy has rage quit. Or that might be my connection, because last game I was actually losing 4-1. And the quick connection lost, and I didn't get a loss. So, yeah, I'm really happy about that. But, yeah, so I would like to thank you all for watching this video. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, remember, drop a like down below. Can we go for a good goal of 5 likes for this return? And tell me if you guys, also, if you want cheap, fast, and reliable games, check out G2A.com, link in the description. If you use my discount, if you use my link, you'll get a 97-cent discount. And also, it'll help me, I guess. And tell me what you guys want to see right now, since I'm not gonna buy FIFA 16. I'm sorry, but it's basically gonna be like FIFA 15 without an old gen. So tell me what games I should play for now. And also, this is actually really important. Tell me where I can get a cheap next gen console anywhere. If maybe even you're willing to sell one, if you have a lot of money. I'm kidding. But yeah, just tell me where I can find one, because so my content can become better. So yeah, I would like to thank y'all for watching, and I will see you guys later. Take care. Bye-bye.